Find a little background music here, I'll do this.
Can you get that?
Alright. Well, now I'll say the same thing in my dialect. See, same thing. You just take the D out and you put the L, that's all it is. It's pretty simple. Anyway, so the songs, you know, like these songs over here, that they're in the local dialect. So here we go, I'll play one for you. They're all originators of vocal composition, so I'll play it and sing it for you.
Mm-hmm.
Silent language. There's no audio portion to that language. And all the words are made with your hands. What kind of language is that?
Sign,
yeah. But is it for deaf people? No. It's for people speaking different. So this is what they came up with. And the best, a lot of you, there's nobody here. Anyway, the best guide to sign language was the Army Training Manual. I think it was put out in the 1860s, I'm not sure. But it's an Army training manual. It's called the Indian Sign Language. And they reprinted it now. You can get it. But this was standard training. And these guys should all know it, these military guys. They should know sign language, because if they were truly replicating that era, they'd know sign. Because all those guys had to, they were trained. That's their training. Because they had to learn it to get by, to live out here. Because that's the language everybody used to travel. Reason why is because everybody has their own language. I'll give you an example. I'll say a simple word in some languages around here. So I'll say the word for coffee. If you do it in sign language, you go like this. Everybody try this. Take your hand like this, and then you go like this. You put those. They had those old grinders. You know, they roast the beans, put them in there, close it up, and then they go like that. So they grind it. Anyway, that's the sign. But the here in this the band right here, the Sisseton, they say Pejuta Sapa. That's how they say it. In Mandan, they say word for coffee, Waraku. The next tribe over in White Shield and Rikra, they say Tskati. In over in Newtown in Mandaree, in Hiraza language, they say Medishibisha. You go down there, I talked to some people from down by Omaha. In Omaha language, they say Monkesabe. In Ho-Chunk or Winnebago down there by Sioux City, they say Lisek. And if you go up here to Turtle Mountain, straight up over there, they say on the Cree side, they say Vigatewapui, it's coffee. On the Ojibwe side, they say Makade Mashkikiwabu. Don't ask for decaf over there. And then where I live over here on Standing Rock, we say Starbucks. No, they say Wakaliapi. That's how you say it. Anyway, so I'll do this demonstration. I'll do a little music, and I'll demonstrate a... okay, let's do this. I'll do the Psalm 23. Does anybody know what that is? You know what that is? And I got this from my mom when she was a little girl. They had the little kids, they taught the little kids how to do sign language. In her generation, they did. So one of the elders in the community there, they're teaching that. So, and of course, I'm going to cheat. When I do this, I'm going to say the English word along with each sign. Otherwise, it's silent, but I'll cheat. And but the reason why I'm going to cheat is I'm going to give you all a test when I get done. Give you this little test. Everybody, pay attention. It's Psalm 23, but I'll do a little music here. So. Okay. Respect for your host and offer them something, maybe whatever you have, maybe offer them a song or something. So I'll do that here. I'll like to dedicate a song here to everybody. And whenever you go places, like if you use the Dakota language, they say, give you all a warm, heartfelt handshake. So that's what the customary. And then so furthermore, I'll offer the song. And it's going to be, I'd like to dedicate an eagle song to everybody here. And this eagle song is it's taken out of sequence. There's a whole series of eagle songs. And they depict the journey of the eagle as eagle flies over this creation. And the eagle is a symbolic of the ascendant nature of the human spirit. And so here it is, this eagle is flying early. It's still dark out. This eagle is compelled to fly upwards. Eagle flies up so high, it flies into the, it sees the light coming into the world. And then the eagle calls out and says, I am the first one to fly with the new day. So it says, Me tokahea ampetu owaki. That's how you say it. Me tokahea ampetu owaki. I'm the first to fly with the day. Next part says, Wambaliga leshka naha anuka san. Hea a u. In other words, this is what the golden eagle and the bald eagle say as they fly with the dawn. So I'd like to, this is like I say, the eagle is just a symbol of the ascendant nature of the human spirit. So I'd like to dedicate the song to all of us eagles in here. We have some eaglets in here, and all of the golden eagles here, all of the, well, not too many black eagles or brown eagles, but white eagles we have. And we have a few bald eagles, too. Okay, this is for all of us eagles in here. So here we go.
Thank you.
About the prairie chicken dancing on a beautiful day. Oh, let me play the tune, and then there's some words, and then we'll teach you the words here. Here's the tune, though. That's the tune. Now there's five words that fit in that melody line. So everybody can say the word. Everybody say, "Sheel."
Sheel.
Sheel is it means a little grouse. A little, not that tall. Next word is wachi. Wachi means to dance. Wait, excuse me. Sheel. Okay. So sheel. Emakie is next word. Everybody say emakie.
Emakie.
Good. That means that he's telling me something. Now. Just make believe. I guess in this case, this bird is talking. So, anyway, what he's saying, the next word you say, wachi, means to dance. Next word you really say, it's got a nasal ending, just like when you say, sha, ha, sa. See, there's two nasals. Sha, cha, ha means a bark. Sa is the off white color, like the milky white color. Like the, it's off white color, beige, I guess. Anyway, in Dakota, they have a nasal, and so there's a nasal sound. Everybody say, "Wachin."
Wachin
means I want, or I want to. Last word, everybody say, "Wahinape."
Wahinape
means I don't know. we'll do this in three parts. So everybody sing it. The first part, I'll sing it. I'll repeat. Everybody sing. Shio, shio, e maki, e.
Shio, shio, e maki,
e. Very good. All right, no lip syncing now. Next part. We'll sing that twice. Next part. Wachi, wachi, wahinape.
Wachi, wachi, wahinape.
Shio, shio, e maki, e.
Shio, shio, maki.
That part we sing twice. Very good. Let's do this a couple times through. Everybody, how they say that? Sing like nobody's listening. And sing like you're in the shower, you know? Nice hot shower, hot tub right now. Sing like that. So, there you go. On the count of three. One, two, three. Shio, shio, e maki, e. Wachi, wachi, wahinape. Shio, shio, e maki, e. Shio, shio, e maki, e. Shio, shio, e maki, e. Wachi, wachi, wahinape. Shio, shio, e maki, e.
Shio, shio, e maki, e.
All right, give yourselves a big hand.
They have a big powwow in Sisseton on the 1st of July.
See that?